The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Many of the Jews had come to Martha and Mary to comfort them about their brother Lazarus, who had died. When Martha heard that Jesus was coming, she went to meet him, but Mary sat at home. Martha said to Jesus, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But even now, I know that whatever you ask of God, God will give you." Jesus said to her, "Your brother will rise." Martha said to him, "I know he will rise in the resurrection on the last day." Jesus told her, "I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, even if he dies, will live, and anyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this?" She said to him, "Yes, Lord. I have come to believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, the one who is coming into the world." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You'll notice today, if you have a missed a letter, if you have a daily reflection book with the readings, we have the two options on this feast. We can either read from the account which we did in St. John's Gospel, where Martha says to the Lord, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died." Or we can take the reading from St. Luke, the famous Martha, "Martha, you are troubled with many things. Mary has chosen the greater portion and will not be denied of it." It's interesting, in both of these readings, we see an assertiveness to Martha, almost, I wouldn't say bold, but a very plain and driven relationship with Christ. Imagine saying, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died." It's just so honest, isn't it? The reality of her sadness, the reality of her grief and her loss. Jesus would go to the tomb of Lazarus, and he would weep. He too knew human grief, loss, sadness at the influence of sin and death. Yet, in his divinity, he knows he is the resurrection and the life. Notice in both cases, Mary is at home. At home at the feet of Jesus, and at home confident in his presence always with her. Let us pray today as we remember the memorial of Martha, that we too must be bold in our relationship with Christ, honest in what we suffer, open to trusting in his providence. Let us stand and pray.